My brothers and sisters in Christ, Shalom. Today I want to make a video to provide an update for you on what is happening in FPBC. People say out of sight, out of mind, but I do not want this to happen to any one of us. You know that the COVID-19 actually resets everything. It upsets everything. I have never seen anything like this before in my lifetime, where schools are closed for an extended period, businesses are closed, even church services have to be closed. And some people say we are now navigating in uncharted waters. Means we are in a place that we have never been before. Now, in times like this, I feel that there are two things that are very important for the church. Number one is that we must continue to communicate. And the second thing that I believe is important for us is that the leadership of the church must continue to provide direction. Now, church, this is exactly what I want to do today with this video. And in short, I want to let you know that we are okay. We are okay. There is no one that is without food right now, because we ensure that everybody's basic needs are met. Now, in the short term, within the next 1 or 2 months, I believe that the FPBC family is going to be fine. But in the long term, we are not certain, because the impact of the COVID-19 is widespread. And there might be some in our midst who might need a longer term of assistance. But what we are going to do is that we must do our best to take care of each other. Just as the tagline says, kita jaga kita. And secondly, the activities of the church are going on fine. We are not able to gather physically, but we are gathering digitally. Almost all of our activities are restored except for Awana and Children's Church. Sunday service, cell meetings, prayer meetings, Chinese church are all digitally connected through YouTube and through Zoom. And on top of that, I also encourage the elders of the church, including myself, to make devotionals as well as to have communication video like this, just to make sure that the church family stays connected. And thirdly, I want to let us know that we are financially okay. It means that bills are paid, our salaries are paid. But we learned from our treasurer that our tithes and offering has come down a little bit, by about a third. And this is understandable because of several factors. Some people may not be comfortable to give their tithes and offering online, and some people may be waiting until the MCO is over. So it is understandable, and we are not too worried about that. We are not worried because our fixed cost is pretty low. And I believe that with prudent spending, our reserves is enough to keep us going for at least a few years. Now, the question is, where do we go from here? What is the direction of the church? Actually, nobody knows what exactly is going to happen 6 months or a year from here. Things are very fluid at this moment. But what I can tell you is that we are planning for the worst. We are preparing for the worst, and we hope for the best. And we are planning for this online service mode to go on until the end of the year. And also, even when the MCO is lifted, the post-MCO gatherings will be carefully managed. For sure, we will not immediately go back to our large meeting. My brothers and sisters, whether we like it or not, digitalization will be part of a new normal for our church. And we need to help each other to adapt to this new normal. Now, what do we as FPBC member need to do now? This is my advice to every one of us. We need everybody to stay connected. Now, how do we stay connected? I urge every one of you to join church activities online, which means that on Sunday morning at 10 a.m., you can tune in to our church service and join our weekly midweek prayer meeting as well. I know that some of you are saying that the weekly prayer meeting is starting too late. We are looking into it, and we will bring it to start a little bit earlier. Okay? But in order for you to be connected online, you need to have a smartphone or a computer, and you need internet to be connected. I know some of you may not have that facility, so please do contact any of our leaders if you have difficulties in connecting to us online, and we will assist you. And secondly, I want to urge all of us to be part of a cell group, to be part of a small group so that you can be cared for. And you can also be continually nourished spiritually and grow in the Lord if you are part of a cell group. If you are currently not part of a CG, I want to urge you to join a CG now. Okay, please contact one of our leaders if you want to join a cell group. So that's all from me today, and I will talk to you again soon. I will see you on our Sunday service and on our prayer meeting. God bless you.